everyone, welcome to View TV with View Magazine. I am your host, Adrena Martober, and thank you for tuning in. And today we have a very special guest with us here today. We have Miss Stacy J of Live 365.
Absolutely.
All right, so happy to have her join us here today. She is a media personality, she's an empowerment coach, and she has an event coming up. She's definitely going to tell us about that and all the other wonderful things she has going on.
I am wonderful, the weather is nice, and I am happy to be here.
Everyone outside, this is the bomb.
Exactly.
Yeah, I see everything going on, everything.
Yeah. So
I want to go ahead and get right into it. So tell us, who is Stacy J? Tell us how you got started, just a little bit of your background.
I'll go with the started. I mean, you know, a lot of times when people ask, you know, who you are, it's like, yeah, I'm a mother,
right.
And I, you know, I'm a girlfriend, and you know, and all these different things, but more so, I'm just a human being that is really trying to live in my purpose. And I know that sounds all, ooh, she's being, you know, spiritual, but that's really the truth of where I am right now.
Right.
So Live 365 started from my father passed away 2 years ago. And before he passed, he always talked about living every day. He's like, stop waiting for vacation, stop waiting to, you know, just plan things, and just be a little bit more spontaneous, because at the end of the day, you die, and you don't know when that is. So it just kind of stuck in my head, and I started with the hashtag, Live365. And soon after, I was like, I want to do an event. And so I thought about what that event would look like, and I wanted to have speakers that were transparent and real, no stuffiness, no phoniness, let's keep it real, and that spoke to our audience, and give them tips and strategies, and even just connecting with the speakers, because sometimes you don't know who's going through what. So this speaker may say something that resonates to you, and this speaker is different elements to it. So I, you know, decided to put the event together, and I thought about the most important areas of our lives, which to me is family, finance, fitness, faith, and following your dreams. So, you know, that's how I put the speakers together. So we have Alexis Miller, which has covered your magazine. She's talking faith. We have Charlinda Parker talking family. We have Leticia Gardner talking fitness. We have Tara, Madam Money Jackson speaking finance. And then we have Marissa Mitchell speaking following your dreams. Our keynote speaker is Darlene. So all my sisters is going to bring it. And it's an empowerment experience, a party is what I like to call it, because as I've said in many interviews, I don't like the stuffy and, you know, let me get my brochure, where we at?
Exactly.
I want everything to be high energy. I want you to have fun while you're being empowered, because life can be heavy. So we want to create, you know, we're going to talk about life, and we want to talk about solutions and being intentional, because that's the theme, the power of intentional living. So we want to, you know, hone on that. We want to push that. But we want you to be able to have fun, laugh at yourself, you know, cry a little bit, but more importantly, connect with the women that's there. I mean, it may be the speakers, it may be the vendors, it may be, you know, someone in the audience, because the way I have it set up, you're going to get to know somebody. Because you're not sitting, no separation, but you're sitting. And I chose this space intentionally, Life Lounge, a restaurant lounge, because my girlfriend Cassandra owns it, and it was just, I want to support her business.
Okay.
And also, it's more intimate, and so that's why I chose that place.
And I like that you said you wanted the speakers. You pretty much want the event to be open and no stuffiness, because just keeping it real here in Atlanta, you go to a lot of events, and it's real, you know, a lot of people, they may be sitting on a panel, but they don't want to keep it real about the different subjects, about faith, family, you know, they're giving you the commercialized version.
Right.
You know, they're not giving it to you, you know, as it should be. So I think that's a great idea, and I like that you put that together.
Oh, thank you.
So Live 365 started 2 years ago, you said, once your father passed.
Right.
Okay. So what else do you offer with the movement, the Live 365?
Well, actually, we have services that also help them in those areas. So you come to the empowerment event, you connect with these other women in whatever area you need, but if you come to me, I do pick my brain sessions, because there's a lot of people that have these ideas, but they don't know how to manifest them. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're thinking it, but they may need just some guidance or getting it kind of out there. So we do pick my brain sessions, media sessions, and also we do project management. So I do work on other people's projects, because I think that it's important that people not only support each other, but you need a team sometimes.
Exactly.
And sometimes we don't have the money to go out and, you know, just hire, but we can work with people on project basis, so we do that as well. But I'm more of a connector.
Okay.
So, you know, I like to say, I don't have a lot of friends, but I know a lot of people.
Okay.
And so it's good to always, that what they talk about your network is true. if you have a great network, if you need something, you call me like, Stacey, I'm looking for, you know, such and so. Or someone needs a videographer or whatever. I like to have all those people in my arsenal so that, you know, that helps the people that I'm trying to, you know, help them. Because some people don't know where to get these resources from.
And I think that's a good thing, too, because a lot of people, like you say, connecting, a lot of people will have resources and know people, but they don't want to give it. You know, they don't want to share those. And I think, you know, that's something as, I don't know if it's just something with women or just something, just in general, but a lot of people, you know, they become successful or they have these resources, but they want to, it's like they're afraid to help somebody else. So it's so important.